Hello and welcome, Leos. I am Pisces Intuition here with your weekly reading. All right, my Leos, let's see what is going on. What is going on? What is coming in? And what do you need to know, Leos? Give us something good. Thank you all for being so patient. Welcome to all my new subscribers and to everybody who has stuck with me. All right, so we have the Eight of Swords, and then I flipped that one. So we're going to put that one back. All right, so Leo, feeling kind of stuck. Some decisions to make, but it just feels like you're kind of stuck. You're in your head, kind of overthinking things is what I keep getting. So we have the Chariot. We have the King of Swords. We have the Nine of Wands. We have the Six of Cups. And we have the Page of Pentacles. Bottom of the deck, we do have the Two of Pentacles. All right. So it's like you're finding a balance. Yes, something is still up in the air. You still need to make some decisions. Right now, you're just kind of stuck in doing so. You're not really making the move. However, it does feel like you're starting to get out of your head. Things are starting, like I said, to get a little bit more clearer. This could be because you are doing some form of meditation. This could be because you are kind of removing yourself from the situation, kind of pulling your power back. Really kind of, like I said, getting out of your head over, you know, stopping the whole overthinking process and just kind of looking at things from a different perspective is what I keep getting here. So it does look like you're going to be making this decision that you need to make rather soon. And it looks like once you do, things really move forward rather quickly. With the Knight of Swords, this could be a communication about a person. Maybe you've been waiting to hear some communication. Maybe you're wanting some answers from a person. And then it's like communication finally does come in. We are out of Mercury retrograde, which is good. It's a plus. So, So communication could have been kind of like, there could have been like some kind of miscommunication. And then it's like this person comes back to kind of clear some things up. For some of you, this is a reconciliation. Yeah, it feels like somebody kind of had you blocked here, Leo, or you had them blocked, but it's like blockages are being removed. Again, I keep getting communication, and it's coming in rather quickly. Because we got a whole bunch of fast, not a whole bunch, but I mean, we've got some really fast movement here. It feels like this person could have been kind of like hot and cold, kind of in and out, and maybe that's what was causing you to really kind of just be, you know, like in your head overthinking, just kind of feel kind of stuck. Because it's like, you don't know what they're doing. You don't know where you stand. And then it's like, you know, if I just had these, you know, if they just like answer my questions or, you know, if I can just like get past their wall, or maybe you had that wall up because this person is kind of like hot and cold. But it's like this person comes back and it's like, no, you know, this is how, you know, like, this is what I want to say to you. It kind of, you know, it's like somebody's revealing their feelings to you is what I keep getting. It does feel like this person's coming in with an apology, because like I said, I keep getting like there's some kind of miscommunication here. Maybe you took, you know, something they said the wrong way, or, you know, this is a general reading, so take it how it resonates. Could be you, could be them. But it feels like I said, a miscommunication, something kind of took something the wrong way. But it does feel like this person is a soulmate energy. We have the Six of Cups here. Yeah, and it feels like you've been waiting on some communication from this person. It's like you hadn't given up hope, but at the same time, you haven't really moved forward. You haven't really, like, done anything. It just feels like you just feel kind of stuck. But it's like once this communication comes in, it picks up. You know, you, like, move forward. You find that balance. Because I keep getting something about balance. Like I said, going back to the Two of Pentacles. Yeah, even though it's still kind of up in the air, it just feels like you're getting things sorted out. And it feels like once communication comes in, you know, you're going to be really happy about it. Like I said, it's going to feel like things get, you know, like cleared up. Like you get the answers that you need. Or like I said, they come in with an apology. Like, oh, no, this is what I meant. You know, you took it the wrong way. And you're like, oh, okay, you know, that makes sense because you had me worried. All right, so again, you know, take it how it resonates. Let's clarify the Eight of Swords, please. And we have the Ace of Cups. Beautiful. All right. So, yeah, definitely kind of stuck in your head, you know, overthinking about, you know, a love situation or about a new beginning. So this could be, you know, kind of a new relationship. You know, again, kind of wondering, are they still dating other people? Are we exclusive? Like, what is the deal? You know, like I said, it's going to resonate differently for everybody. But, you know, your situation, you know what you've been overthinking about, you know what's in your head. But it does feel like this is about, you know, a romantic situation, a relationship here. All right, let's clarify the Chariot, and we have a flipper. Oops. We have two flippers. We have the Four of Cups and the Queen of Swords. So, yeah, so wondering if this is, you know, like an unrequited love. Should you just cut it out? Should you move forward? Like, you know, cut the strings, cut the cord, you know, however, and should you just move forward? But there, you know, like I said, it feels like there's a miscommunication with something here because it does feel like this person is coming back. Yeah, it feels like there's still love here. But you need something to kind of clear it up for you. You need some answers. You need some open, honest communication. And you're willing to hear them out. You want to openly talk. You want communication with this person. But yeah, it feels like, you know, this is not a missed opportunity. It feels like a new opportunity is coming in. You just don't see it because you're just kind of focused on like the overthinking of something. All right, let's clarify the Knight of Swords. We have two cards again. We have the Eight of Pentacles and we have Temperance coming out. So again, lacking focus. It feels like your person is kind of lacking focus, or maybe again, you know, general reading, take it how it resonates, could be you. But it feels like somebody's kind of lacking focus. Like I said, kind of in and out, hot and cold. And we need to find that balance. We need to really kind of pull that in, make sure both of us are putting in the same amount. You know, of energy, one person can't be doing all the work, you know, wondering like, okay, I'm holding this relationship, but where have you been for like the last week or two? You know, something like that, because that's not going to work. You know, I'm just exaggerating here, but you get what I mean. But again, kind of just going with the flow, bringing in some healing, of course. Like I said, definitely finding that balance, definitely focusing on what it is that we want. Because like I said, I keep getting very strongly a miscommunication. So somebody really needs to kind of clear that up. I keep getting like throat chakra, you know, being blocked. So definitely something needs to be cleared up here. All right, Nine of Wands, clarify that. Okay, once again, two cards. Okay, Leo. Eight of Swords and the Seven of Wands, clarifying the Nine of Wands here. All right, so being very defensive, you know, kind of defending, fighting for what you want, fighting for what you, fighting for yourself, defending yourself. It's like you're trying to find that balance. But, you know, things are just really difficult. Like I said, you just feel really stuck. Like you don't have much of a choice, much of an option. Not wanting to give up, but again, needing some kind of clarity here. I keep getting somebody asking, like, is this going to work? Can we make this work? Okay, and surprise, surprise, two more cards. Clarifying the Six of Cups, we have the Emperor and we have the Star card. So wish fulfillment with the Six of Cups. The Emperor, it's like somebody does finally take control of the situation, tries to kind of bring back balance, tries to, like I said, fix right or wrong, you know, fix the situation. Again, I keep feeling like somebody is coming in with an apology. Okay, and we have one card. clarifying the Page of Pentacles, we have the Nine of Pentacles. So we have a very, I keep getting stubborn, but it's, you know, it's that card of, you know, really just kind of doing your own thing, you know, relying on yourself, trusting yourself, knowing you've got your own back. You know, you are stable. You are, again, you know, rocking that inner strength. Yeah, and it's like once you get that, not that you need an apology, but it's like, you know, once you get that, it kind of has you feeling like you're on top of the world. Like, okay, things are cleared up. You know, I'm feeling good now. You know, now I got this. We can move forward. It's like you get like a confidence boost or something here. because it's like this person does come back and they're like, you know, expressing, like I said, not only an apology, but that they would like to start something with you. Because I am getting, like I said, a new beginning here, especially with this Ace of Cups, a new beginning, like in love or in a situation here. All right, let's get some Oracle cards for Leo. Any advice or anything that Leo needs to know? Okay, we have three. We have the World card. So a new cycle. I keep getting a change with the World too. I keep getting change of the season. So next season is fall. Look for something around like August, September for some kind of change here, something coming in. Then we have man holding a heart. So again, somebody coming in, offering their feelings, offering their love, you know, offering that cup, offering some kind of apology as well as what I keep getting, opening up communication, showing you their loyalty. Then we have the third chakra. So this is all about solar plexus. So again, this is talking about, you know, when you think of your solar plexus, you think of, you know, that's your power. That's where your power is. So definitely pulling your power back, focusing it more on you, because it does feel like you are putting a lot into this situation. But this situation is also kind of stressing you out and putting you in your head. So, you know, you kind of need to pull back a little bit. And like I said, really kind of focus on you. All right, let's get some more Oracle, please. Okay, so we have storm fields. So definitely some unexpected stuff coming in. Yeah, like I said, it just feels like things got really confusing. Things got kind of mixed up, and I keep getting it has something to do with communication, like somebody took something the wrong way. All right, then we have the card of goblins. Yeah, it makes sense. Yeah, it makes sense that these two cards came out together because, you know, Stormfields, like I said, it's like something unexpected kind of coming your way. You know, think of, you know, look at that tornado kind of going on, kind of causing some, you know, chaos. But at the same time, you know, it's that uncomfortableness. It's, you know, that chaos, that, you know, that turmoil, like, you know, again, that feeling stuck, you know, feeling like you're overthinking, feeling just, you know, in your head. And it could be, you know, like because of conflict, like I said, again, somebody taking something the wrong way or no communication or something along those lines. Communication needs to be opened up in order for that to get fixed. That's the bottom line. However, you know, just remember, a tornado, when it touches down, it does not last forever. No storm lasts forever, okay? And that's just like what, you know, in life, you know, this is going to pass as well. With the goblins, you know, goblins, you kind of think of, you know, being scared, you know, your fears. And it's just saying that, you know, fear, it's just in your, it's an illusion. You know, again, that Eight of Swords being stuck in your head. You know, when we don't have the answers that we need to questions that we are asking, especially when somebody's kind of in and out, not really giving us, you know, the stability that we need or the, you know, again, the answers to our questions, you know, we tend to really kind of turn into our own minds. We start overthinking, you know, then that kind of creates some kind of illusion. You know, sometimes it creates fear, you know, definitely kind of, you know, dealing with wounds, but it's just saying that, you know, forgive yourself, forgive others, you know, look towards, you know, the focus on the here and now, you know, focus on you, on your healing, and choose love. Don't choose fear, you know, choose love. All right, because that is going to help you ultimately, like I said, you know, with the healing process and moving yourself forward. All right, let's get some romance angels. Okay, we have free yourself. So for some of you, you know, you're like this in and out energy, you know, I can't do it. Then we have, it is safe for you to love. So again, you know, the ball is in your court. We all have free will. Whether you choose to stay with this person, whether, you know, you accept their apology, you know, of course that is fully up to you. You know, what do you want to do? Do you want to accept their apology and move forward? Or do you just want to free yourself and focus more on you? All right, Leo, let's get a couple more Oracle here. All All right, so we have Spirit of the Pumpkin, Autumn, Harvest, and Midnight. Okay, so again, I kept getting something about the turn, you know, the next season. So like I said, that would be fall time. So definitely look for some kind of changes or something having to do with like fall time. Like I said, I keep getting like August, September. So again, just kind of focus on that because it just feels like a new beginning. All right. So let's get some love messages here. Okay, we had two. All right, so we have the Dove. And then we have this one. We have freedom. There is nothing stopping you. The path is clear if you want it to be. So again, free yourself. You know, the ball is in your court. And again, what did I say? New beginning. A new adventure awaits. Embrace it and live your dreams passionately. All right. So yeah. So guys, some new beginnings coming in. Like I said, around fall time, you know, autumn time, new beginnings and passion, love, chemistry, you know, all that. So really not that far away. So for those of you, like I said, this choice is yours. The ball is in your court. So do what you will with it. Thank you guys so very much for stopping by. I do hope this helps your situation. And until next time, take care.